telescopes flew into target. Telescopes flew complete.
Rock said that you only need the heater. The heater is to keep the optical window from condensing, and it's only needed if you're in a high humidity environment when you're running the cooler. So he says, but generally only set it to about mid-range. Evening, Bobby. I'm trying to catch Lagoon and Triffid before they get eaten by the pine tree. If one pine tree had not blown over in the storm, it would already be behind the pine tree. But a big, massive pine tree blew over in the storm in my neighbor's yard. Right now I got a 10-second exposure and I got the gain at 50. I'm using darks that I had obtained back in September, so they may not be appropriate right now. See if I can change the exposure, maybe I'll go to 15 seconds. Tonight I'm using the LenHance filter as opposed to the Optolong that I was using the other night. And I also remembered to put the camera in color mode tonight as opposed to grayscale, like Sunday night. I'll check it when I get in tonight. Light shield down, block the lights from the monitor, see if that helps any. Because my computer monitor is in the southwest corner of the building and that's where I'm aiming right now. Done a Lagoon and Triffid. That was my first target on my list because I had to catch them before they entered the tree. Not bad for 15 seconds and half gain. Zoom to 100%. Right now I'm at altitude 20 degrees. And I think that tree is getting closer. I might have seen that earlier, Bobby. I spent the whole day outside trying to clean up from the Hurricane Zeta limb damage everywhere. I'm gonna try bumping the exposure to 20 seconds. Okay. I hope to have some more DS26Cs in about 2 to 3 weeks. I was talking to Rock about that this morning. Evening, Greg. Welcome aboard. It's been a while. See, I zoomed to 100% there. That LenHance filter really blocks the blue of that reflection nebula next to 20, next to the Trifid. Oh, that I haven't stopped. Yeah, that I haven't stopped. There was somebody else that sent me an email today about 26C. Flew over to the Eagle and Swan.
Telescope slew into target.
Let me stop the
telescope slew complete
stacking. Yeah, the tree was getting close to Lagoon. Reduce the exposure to about 15 seconds. So not 15 seconds. It really hasn't gotten fully dark yet. I think astronomical twilight ends at in about 13 minutes. Okay, let me start stacking now. Let me apply the right dark. I only had a 10 second in there, so let me import a... Should I either have a 10 or a 20? I'll try with a 20. And now I'll start live stacking.
Okay.
The physical field of view from corner to diagonal corner is 5.82 degrees based upon what astrometry said. Got an email from Mike Nicely today. He said that William Optics just introduced a field flattener with 0.8x focal reduction for the Zenithstar 61. So I contacted somebody at OPT to see how long it's going to take to get one. I think they're on order coming. Field of view would be slightly smaller, but hopefully I'll get rid of some of that coma at the edge. That's 100%. So let me now increase the exposure a little. Stop, let's go to 20 seconds. And add those into the stack. To see if Cygnus is past the meridian. I wonder if the helix is going to be behind the neighbor's oak tree. Maybe I'll try that next. Probably be real small. Let's stop the stacking.
T- Telescope slew into target.
Okay.
Telescope slew complete.
Well, there it is. Let me see if I can get it closer to the center. That bright star, I want to move that bright star to about here. Okay, so let's stop. Let me go to about 3 seconds, loop. Okay, that star is still there, so let's... Oh, I did a meridian flip, so now I gotta change east and west. Let me change the slew rate. Okay, so that should be pretty close to where I want to be. Let's go back to the 20-second exposure. Loop. 20 seconds. Hopefully I'm still live. Now I'm going to start live stacking. Can anybody confirm that if I'm still live? Okay. Thank you, Bobby. I don't think I've looked at the helix in a while. Where am I now? 36 degrees up. And we're almost at the end of twilight. So Jeff, about half gain at 50. You normally go higher than that, or? I know you normally at F11. I'm at about F4.4, I think it calculated at.
Telescope synced.
Okay. I mean, it's not looking bad for as big a field of view as I have. And I'm capturing an image every 30 seconds. I got 44 captured already. Plus, I'm recording another screen video. What else is around the... Helix. Oh, Sculptor. I wonder if I can get the Sculptor galaxy. That's pretty low right now. It's about 18 to 20 degrees up right now. Well, I'm on the east side of the meridian. Maybe I could do those later. Let's see. Let me see where Cygnus is right now. Let's go to... Cephas, Cygnus. I'm plotting the interactive atlas. Let's see where it says we are. Okay, what the heck? I'm gonna go to North American.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
Okay. Maybe I should have stopped this book, the stacking. Yep. Stop the stack. Okay, so now I gotta
telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
Too much red, I think. Well, maybe I gotta lower the saturation. little bit more.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
I'm going too high. I gotta bump it down a little. I was using 1 minute last night with the LenHance filter. Oh, satellite. So let me go. I want to move that down. So I'm going to.
Telescope slew into target.
Hopefully I slewed down and not up.
Telescope slew complete.
Wrong way. Oh no, wait, maybe not. Went the wrong way. Definitely went the wrong way.
Telescope slew into target. Telescope slew complete.
I'm going to have to just manually, Hi, Rusty. Okay, it's there now. Now to start playing with the, I might have to go with a longer exposure. Second loop and let me apply a 30-second dark. Let's see what happens. Yeah, I had to did a little short solar today. Oh, yeah, that's right. You were on, Jeff. Yeah, that spot's ought to be nice in a day or so, and it moves a little bit further onto the disc. I might try. Let me stop this. I'm going to go to something even longer. I'm going to go to 45 seconds and see what happens. Let me stop 45 loop. I created some 45 and 1 minute darks today. Yeah, except for that one sunspot area, there wasn't a whole lot going on in the sun. Even the proms were weak at best. Like last night I was using 100% gain and a much longer exposure because of the filter I was using. You can see that bright star in the top right corner. It's slightly elongated, so I know I have some coma. This is starting to look pretty good. I forget the name of that nebulosity that's below.
Telescope synced.
Yeah, thank you, Rusty. It's looking pretty good, especially for this little small scope. Yeah, William Optics makes some nice refractors. Jeff, they were saying that solar flare caused some radio blackout. Yeah, Rusty, I looked at the Helix right before the North American. Yeah. Welcome, Terry. Due to saturation, maybe move the saturation. Maybe I'll go to 105 with the saturation. Like the time back in standard time so you can start observing early. It's only 6:40 and it's already dark. Okay, well let's see. Leave the what was saturation at 100? I moved the contrast. How much to move it? I only moved it 5. Eighty-eight for saturation. Let's see what it looks like. Contrast to 16. Okay, let's see what happens. It'll definitely take the red out of the nebula. Yep, I was thinking about going up to a minute next. Add a few more to the stack and then bump it up to a 1 minute exposure. I got 7 in the stack now. I was playing with what I had captured 2 nights ago when I had it set to grayscale and played with colorizing it and was able to bring out a lot more detail. Of course, not having the right darks didn't help because there was a lot of warm pixels. I don't know if anybody, if you can read what at the bottom I have the scope and the focal reducers and filters I'm using. And at the top I have how I have the camera set up. Yeah, and having the gain at 100, I did have a lot of noise. I do have the sharpness off. Sharpness is disabled or off. I have the low noise off. The heater for the optical window I have off, and the cooling is set to 0. 0 centigrade. So now I'm going to bump it up to a 1 minute exposure. Stop. Loop. And erase that. Now let's go to 60 seconds. Okay. I thought you told me to turn the low noise off yesterday, Jeff. Yeah, low noise is off. Yeah, Rock didn't answer my question about low noise. I have to talk to him about that tomorrow. I think we're getting the first of the 1 minute exposures adding to the stack now. Came in. Yes. Evening, Will. Oh, I see Astro Greg. Greg left. Yeah, okay. Let me zoom into 100%. Not looking bad at all. And I forget the number of this nebula across the bottom. Oh yeah. Yeah, Norfolk Southern Railroad is 1 mile to my east. South. A lot of freight on that line. two Amtraks a day and lots of freight. Yeah, that line leads directly to New Orleans. And then from there, it can go almost anywhere. West Coast, Northwest, you name it. What else? Yeah, you could take North would be going to Chicago. You could transfer over to the LNN line. Head to the West Coast or to Jacksonville. This is not looking shabby at all. Yep. After this, I'm probably going to go to the area around Sater. What is it? Gamma Cygni? Let me stop the live stack. Let me start with a 30. Oh, I didn't put the 1 minute dark in. Oh well. I'm going to loop and I'm going to go over to Sater.
Telescopes flew into target. Telescope slew complete.
I think the other night I put Sater near the top left corner and I got the crescent in the bottom right. So let me move. I want to take that star and put it somewhere around here. Okay. So let's stop the exposure. Let me go to about a 3 second exposure. Maybe to loop, and then Okay, so stop. I'm gonna start with 45 seconds, I think. Loop 45. And I'm gonna add a 45 second dark. Let's see what happens. So this should be the Sator Nebula, and hopefully I got the crescent in the bottom right corner. Too far. Yeah, I'm gonna move it back. I'm gonna move. I'm gonna put that bright star right about there. Stop. Too much. That's close enough. Go back to 45. Loop. So I'm at 45 seconds right now. This is what 30. Hopefully I'm still alive. Okay, thanks, Rusty. Yeah, Rock was checking on what happened on Sunday. He hasn't gotten back with me on that yet. Bump this up to 1 minute shortly. I got to get a few more in the stack though.